how my, yeah, it's red, has changed to a different color. Well, it's winter outside. Can't do much motorcycling. And so we've been doing a number of things on the motorcycle anyway to get it prepared for the spring. So anyway, I'm going to show you what I've done over the winter and how my, yeah, it's red, has changed to a different color.
So I said I've been doing a number of things over the winter on my new acquisition, the 2002 ST1100. So I've been working on a couple of things. Recently I acquired this tire pressure monitoring system. I wasn't too sure about this to begin with, but the more I thought about it is that generally I don't check the tire pressure on my vehicle all that much. And a couple of times it's caught me off guard. And one, it partially because it's a little bit hard to check the tire pressure on the pan. It takes a little bit of work. Even though I have 45 degree valve stems, to check the rear, generally it's easier if I take the pannier off and then I have to lie on the ground to get the gauge on it. And what prevented me from getting one of these tire pressure monitoring systems before was the cost of it. They were well over $100 or so, up to $200. And just for giggles, I checked on eBay, and I found them for $32 Canadian. So I just have the bare basic one. It gives me tire pressure, front and rear, and also gives me the temperature of the air in the tire. So, and it will warn me if the tire pressure gets too high or too low, and same with the air temperature. So it's a nice little unit, and I'll show you that on the bike in a bit. When I had the bike apart, I also got LED headlights. So I am fortunate because I acquired a European headlight, and that headlight allows me to use regular H4 bulbs without a shim. Because the proprietary ones in North America were 45 watt, and in Europe they can use the 55 and 60 watt bulbs. And those bulbs have a different tab system on them. The proprietary one, the angle of the tabs that fit into the headlamps are slightly different, and so if you want to replace it with the readily available H4 bulbs, you have to cut tabs off and then put the shim in. So I've alleviated that with the European headlight. So I'll show you that in a bit. I have my GPS installed on the new bike as well, and then I put a hood. We get some bit of glare without a hood, so I'll show you that. I made a tank bra and tank bag to match this bike. I did that on my 97, but it was a bright red, a pearl red, and this one is a wineberry red, so I've done that. I acquired a different top box for this unit. I'm not a fan of top boxes, but I found one that looks like pretty close to the ones that were issued by Honda for the Pan-European, and so I've got it. I still have to wire it yet, so there are a couple of LED lights on the back, and I also want to put a power supply in there. So I will show you what I've done on my bike, and we'll take it from there. So my bike is currently on a homemade lift. I can use a jack to raise that up, and then I have some horses for it to be up in the air, but right now it's back down. Here's a seat that I acquired. last fall. It's a sergeant seat with a backrest made by Utopia. So I got this from a fellow forum member, and acquired that. So I'm anxious to try that out. Normally I have a Corbin seat, but it's covered in the leather that's coloring match the 97, and this one is generic. So back here is that top box that I acquired. It fits on a regular GV unit on a monokey. It'll hold a helmet easily, a full modular helmet, which is kind of nice. It has lights back here, which I will wire for my brake lights. Here is the tank bag that I made. That's the tank bag. This is the tank bra. Because the shelter cover is made out of plastic or fiberglass, it's not magnetic, so I can't use a magnetic tank bag. But there was a company in Europe called Bagster that made units, so I basically plagiarized their design. But I modified a tank bag, and this is the design I made for my previous bike. It has a map cover on the top and two side pockets, and there's a power supply inside. There is my GPS with a hood that I made, or a collar, like a pet collar, to go around it, and we'll see how that works. Here I have a phone mount. Oh, and my tire pressure gauge just came on here. So the temperature in the tires is 2 degrees Celsius or 1, and the rear tire is at 40 pounds per square inch, and the front one's at 41. So anyway, that's what that unit is. So it'll go to sleep, and when you bounce it or bump it, it wakes up, and it pretty much gives you accurate tire pressure at real time. Over here, I transferred this control unit. This is from a Goldwing 1500, so it has a cruise control on it. And I have a Rostra cruise control in the tail section of my bike, and it's hooked up to the carburetor, so this makes it an easy unit instead of having a separate controller for that. And I have the Oxford heated grips. I installed the OEM switches. So there's a bezel that you can buy, and this is on the police bikes, but you can get these at Partzilla. And then you can get a hazard switch, and I opted for a driving light switch. And below I have a cigarette lighter adapter for that. I have PIA lights in the front, and we can see that's, you can't really tell the European headlight. There's a slightly different pattern here, but you can see how bright it goes. So here it is there. Whoa! So that's the LED, and then when we put brights on that, and with my switch engaged, I have the PIA lights as well. I installed a new front tire. The bike came with new tires, etc., bias plies, but this is being an ABS model. The front tire is a larger one. It is a 120 instead of a 110. And so I installed that. And down here is the sensor for the tire monitoring pressure system. So it just screws up on the cap and sends a signal to the receiver, which is on my handlebars. The bike also came with a brand new GV windshield, but I added a unit here. This is a wind deflector, and this is a great device. You can adjust it, so you can adjust the height. And it gives you a little bit of a quieter ride behind it. So that's basically what we've got. So this is what's been keeping me busy over the winter. The 97 is all the Tupperware is off, so come spring I got to put that back on. I also have to put the handlebars back on. I switched the handlebars off of the 97 because they're helibars, which are more adjustable, which I wanted to transfer to this bike, to the new one, which I did. Which means I've got to put the other handlebars back on. I have to put the headlight back on and put all the Tupperware back onto the bike. And then it'll probably be, I'm pretty sure I'm going to sell it. So it'll be on the market in end of April, beginning of May. So if you like the video, well, you know the drill. You just click the thumbs up. If you didn't, well, thumbs down. And if you wish to subscribe, well, there's a subscribe button as well. All the best. See you in the spring. Well, it's winter outside. Can't do much motorcycling. And so we've been doing a number of things on the motorcycle anyway to get it prepared for the spring. So anyway, I'm going to show you what I've done over the winter and how my, it's red, has changed to a different color.